Hey guys and dolls, how's everybody doing today? Before I get into the topic today of, you know, how to do your taxes, I just wanted to mention something real quick. A few videos ago, I kind of snuck a little message in there asking everybody of, you know, if you're going to see something in the next few videos that was the same. And I just wanted to here mention, for the past few videos, I have not changed my top, I have not changed my location, and I just filmed here. So it'll be interesting for me to know if anybody noticed it, so just leave it in the comments below. But anyway, moving on to the topic of how to do your taxes. Don't be afraid of taxes. If you are just now doing taxes for the first time, don't be afraid of it. It is not a difficult thing. I promise you, you can get all the forms online. The very top link in the description will take you to the government site where you can get your tax forms. Please do not pay someone to give you tax forms or to download tax forms. Tax forms are free. The information of how to file taxes is free. Used to, they had booklets that they printed and tax forms that were available in the post office. So depending on where you live, they may still do that. You could check it out. But if not, like I said, everything is online. Okay, I am not a bookkeeper. I'm not an accountant or anything like that. I am an individual that has filed taxes. I am am a business owner, so those are different kind of taxes. I have made a bunk ton of money some years, so that's another level of taxes. But for most people, it's just pretty much your paycheck and taxes. I mean, you know, even if you own a home and things like that, it's going to be pretty simple to do your taxes. Don't be afraid of it. Most people are going to use the EZ form or they're going to use the 1040. Okay. And like I said, neither one of those are difficult. Now, if you have a lot of things, if you're a person that sells online, because I know a lot of my community members are, and you ran a business from your home, you probably would benefit from talking to a bookkeeper or a tax, specialist. Okay. You don't, try to do it on your own first, because I always feel like if you just turn stuff over to experts without even knowing how to do it, that's a problem because you're not taking responsibility for your own monies, okay? Now, the benefit of using someone who is an expert in the field, they can find you more deductions, okay? So, like I said, I would suggest that you do your taxes and then just to double check it, take it to a professional and they might could find some other things for you. Step one, basically, go online, figure out which form you're going to need. That's going to be based on your income and based on any deductions you have. So like if you own a home and you're paying a mortgage, that's going to be a benefit to you. If you have children, that's going to be a benefit to you. These are all different kinds of deductions, okay? If you have a lot of medical expenses, that's a thing. If you have a business, you know, if you're a small business owner, that's going to be a thing. So all these layers is what's going to make your taxes not harder, it's just there's more papers to fill out, literally. But long story short, if you go to work and you get a paycheck and that's pretty much it, the easy form is going to be the one that you do. And it is literally usually a front and back page. And it's almost like, what was your income? You know, look on your form that you get at the end of the year and fill out the information of how much taxes you've had taken out. It's really simple. It's really, really simple. Go to the link that I've put below. Find out which tax form you need to use, and that's going to be based on your income and based on deductions. Print it out. Go by step. Don't start at step 12 and then go back to step 3. Start at step number 1. On the forms, it's numbered. This is number 1. This is number 2. This is number 3. And a lot of times it'll say, if, you know, 4 is less than 5, input 0. Or if 7 is more than 12 below, then come back here and put in this number. The instructions are right there on the form. And if you have a question about the instruction, many times it will refer you to the page in the booklet, in the tax information booklet, to go and look and understand. I remember the first time that I did, that I was self-employed and I did taxes on my own, it was a little daunting because I didn't even know some of these other forms existed because I'd always done the 1040s or the EZ form. And so it was just very strange to see all these forms. But don't let it freak you out because, again, it's just another piece of paper that you have to fill out. So there you go. Not so much of a tutorial, but just some information of how to find out how to do your taxes. Go online to irs.gov. Everything you could ever want is on that site. Now, I'm not going to be trite and silly and just say go there and look it up, because I know it freaks a lot of people out, especially if it's your first time filing taxes, if it's your first time filing taxes as a self-employed person. So all those things are something to consider, right? Okay, so first of all, do you need a specialist? You know, do you need a bookkeeper? Do you need one of those tax preparer services? No, you don't. Generally, most of the people in the United States of America that goes to work, takes home a paycheck, and that's it. They don't need a tax specialist, okay? I always suggest everybody do their own taxes, and then if you want somebody to check it, then by all means. If you have a really involved situation, if you are self-employed and possibly you do contract work and you were somewhere where you got a paycheck and you have more than one property that you own and you have a rental property and you had a lot of medical expenses and a lot of moving expenses, then yes, you probably would need somebody to check it for you, but generally you don't. You can do it yourself. So, you know, if you go to irs.gov, one of the first links you're going to find is, do I need to file a tax return? It's right there in the middle. Click it. Find out. Okay. If you're under a certain amount of income a year, generally you don't have to file. But if you paid taxes, like if you had withholding that was taken out, in other words, if you were employed somewhere, then you could get that money back if you didn't make up to a certain amount a year. So it's worth it, you know, pretty much to file your taxes anyway if you've made an income. Okay. So just kind of thinking that rule of thumb. Now there's all kinds of forms. There's the 1040, the 1040 EZ. There's 1099s, there's W-2s, there's W-4s, you know, there's at the beginning when you get employed, but don't even worry about that, okay? Because again, if you go to irs.gov, you're going to figure out what form that you need to use. The 1040 EZ is the basic, I went to work and I paid bills. That's generally the one everybody's going to use. If you had any other kind of income, if you have any other kind of random expenses or any kind of wild amounts of deductions, then you're going to have to do the 1040, okay? Also, different kind of income can be things like not just, you know, getting a paycheck. It can be child support. It can be alimony. It can be sometimes scholarships or grants or loans for school plays into needing to file taxes. Deductions, things that you're going to find out about are random things, believe it or not, like can you deduct your gambling losses? In some instances, you can. If you had a whole lot of moving expenses, if you had a whole lot of, if you own a property, if you own your home, if you're paying a mortgage, all those things are things that you can think about and that you need to include when filing your taxes. But biggest overarching thing of all this is, number one, don't freak out about it. Number two, you don't need a specialist. All the information is in the forms that are available online to you. I believe you can also get them from your local library. So if you don't have internet access, you can go there. They should have forms, or they can help you print out forms. So it's really not that big a deal. But please don't freak out. I know a lot of people do freak out. It's really not that big a deal. Okay. I'm not saying don't go to a specialist. I'm saying go to one if you have a lot of stuff that you need to have checked. But if you just went to work and got a paycheck, you can file your own taxes. So on that note, guys and dolls, have a delicious, delightful, delirious day, and I'll see you next time.